Jerry slithered his way down unfamiliar halls. After spending quite a bit of time with the multi-hued animal kingdom, he suddenly felt the urge to get away, to separate himself from the pack again. Scott the Elf was too engrossed in a biography of Charles Dickens to notice Jerry slipping through the outdoor as the second shift left. Unfortunately, Jerry had gotten himself lost in the maze of workshops, bone centers, and office areas that comprised Santa's headquarters. It all seemed so mundane. Jerry was just sentimental enough to expect some sort of red and white gingerbread-style affair. Instead, all he had seen for the past three quarters of an hour was a sea of putty-colored office furniture. He was sure he was never going to find the front of the building when he noticed a quiet tapping noise coming from the far end of the hall. He tracked the sound to a broom closet at the very end and nudged his way in the door. Jerry felt like he had entered a different building entirely. The little broom closet appeared much larger than it did from outside the door. There were several small workbenches, all heavily laden with toys of all sizes and shapes. Little toy soldiers, beautiful cloth dolls, tops, boats, the works. At the workbench at the far end of the room sat a round little man tinkering away at a toy train. Santa turned at the creak of the door, glanced in Jerry's direction, and started to return to his work. Then he paused for a moment and turned back and looked down at Jerry there on the floor.
"Well, hello there, little fellow," Santa's perfect baritone boomed. "I almost didn't see you there. I'm sorry, but I finished the geraniums last week."
Jerry stammered a response that was nearly, but not entirely, unlike, "I'm not here for food."
"Ho, ho, ho! There's a stout fellow," Santa replied. "So what brings you to my little shop if not for food, hmm?"
Jerry regained his composure and said in his proudest, most businesslike voice,
"I lead a group of pilgrims. We have traveled many miles to learn our role in the wonder of Christmas from the master himself."
Santa chuckled and took a puff of his nearly floor-length pipe.
"Well, my lad, I'll tell you. The best role you can be in right now is that of tool finder. I can't find my socket set. The missus keeps hiding it from me, doesn't like me tinkering around in that dusty old broom closet. So could you see your way clear to give us a hand, a foot, some help?"